thing I will tell you is how to do a playback, because in a SafeBridge video they just say press transverse button, all you have to click on playback and it should playback. As you can see, nothing happened. I will show you again. Press transverse button, press the playback button, and you can see nothing happened. So this is not told into SafeBridge. All you have to do is go to task list, go to configuration, and you have to exit from this. You have to exit from this main NaviSailor. Navigation mode is about to be terminated. Are you sure you want to exit? Yes. So NaviSailor is exited this. Now if after coming out, if you click on this playback, it won't playback. You have to wait for 4 to 5 seconds. At least 5 seconds. So you wait 4 to 5 seconds. Now you click playback, and now the playback function will work. So that's how a playback system works on this transverse. You have to exit from the system. This is kind of a tip because it's not told into the video of SafeBridge. And then whatever date you want to just, you can select here, you can select the date. It's just a very simple process. It's just like a computer. You can start it and your ship movement will start. You want to do it by forward 1:60. You can see the ship is moving. So this is a playback. This is playback, whole playback system. To exit from, you can see mode replay. If you want to exit, stop this. Close. Playback mode is about to be terminated. Yes. And again, if you want to go back to your ECDIS screen for navigation, if you suddenly come out and press this, it won't open. You have to wait for 4 to 5 seconds. We'll wait. And then we will click on this NaviSailor. And then your NaviSailor ECDIS navigation mode will open. So this is always a thing that always these grids will open. Whenever you restart your ECDIS or you start from scratch, these grids will open. So to remove this grid, by grids I mean the line, these vertical line, latitude, longitude lines. So to remove this, you have to go to charts, go to layers, and when I click this, uncheck this grid, this latitude, longitude lines are gone. This is by default the function that grids will open. So that's how you playback into transverse ECDIS. Now the second one, then we'll talk about another thing. Many people don't know how to use this EBL and VRM, because that's how it is. As you can see, if I switch on, you can see, I'll just zoom in. So you can see I've switched on this EBL and VRM. And if I click offset, you see it's just going offset to one particular line. I'll show you once more by, I'll just uncheck this, I'll close these. I'll go to EBL and VRM to set maximum VRM. So the maximum VRM is 1.2. So I'll just randomly change some setting. Click on offset. You can see that's all. That's all I can do. That's all I can work with. This is the EBL and VRM. This is the drawback with this ECDIS. It is just that this VRM and EBL will only move maximum to the range of 10.2 nautical miles. So within 10.2 nautical mile of this, my ship's position, 10.2 nautical mile of my ship position, only there the VRM can move. So let me show you what I mean. For example, I want to move it over here. So let me take the bearing. So the bearing is 27 and range is 5.58. Let's see, I'll reduce this by the cursor. I can reduce. I'll switch on this EBL and VRM. Firstly, they will come on the ship's position. As you can see, it is always encircled on the ship's position. Now if I want to offset it, it will automatically go to 27.5 degree. So from my ship position, it will go to 27.5 degree, and from there it will make a 5.2 nautical mile circle. Let us click offset, and this is how it is. Maximum this circle you can do is, as I told earlier, you can see on the bottom, 10.2 nautical mile. So within, from the ship position, maximum it can go to 10.2 nautical mile range. So within this ship's position, 10.2 nautical miles. Same for EBL1, EBL2, anything.